21st century. We live in an era where being fat is the new normal. More than half of the Earth's population is pumped up, but this isn't the case in our past. Being fat was considered as a serious disease. This generation accepted being fat as being cute. We humans evolved so much that we find a new way or a meaning to get comfortable with uneasy truths. Most of you who are watching this might have tried various ways to reduce your fat, but ended up accumulating even more. Because dieting and fitness programs doesn't work. But the good news is there is only one single way to lose your fat and get the shape of your dreamy imaginations. Here in this episode of Mature Beings, we will discuss about the myths, the reason why we get fat, how to get rid of it, and the ways to avoid getting fat again. Before that, if you are new here, then welcome to the tribe. For a lifetime growth, improvement and transformation topics, become a part of our tribe by subscribing that red eye-catchy subscribe button below the video. If you are done subscribing, then let's enter the show. One, green tea will reduce fat. Green tea is essentially a zero calorie drink and it contains flavonoids, but in a very small quantities. Just sipping on green tea throughout the day without managing your diet isn't going to make you lose fat. 2. Lemon plus honey plus warm water equals melting fat. This myth is overspread as hell. The claim that having hot water in the morning melts fat is simply not true. If you want to sip warm water with honey, lemon or anything else in it, you surely can. Just don't expect any miracle fat loss. Your daily diet plays a key role in reducing the fat portions of the body. No pain, no gain. This is overtaken by many gym freaks. Sweat is your fat crank. It's fine for your WhatsApp status and Instagram story, but it has no bearing to reality. You need to balance your cardio with weight training and core strengthening to get perfect results. 4. Dieting is the only way to lose fat. Keto diet, low carb diet, crash diet, or any kind of new diet is introduced, there is a whooping blaze of hype around it. In reality, there is no such magic diet that can make you leaner. There are also no superfood that can make your fat melt away. The people in the market are earning loads of money by just using your insecurities and lack of knowledge. In fact, quite often, we even overlook the bad effects that such diet can cause on our health. 5. There is an ongoing debate in our households about the reason why we get fat. To generalize this concept in a simple words, we are surrounded by a thought that we get fat simply by consuming more calories than we need. This is the most noted concept all around the globe, but this is one of the false rumors which has spread in the early days of obese people. After further time, people came to understanding that if we intake lower calories, then we can reduce body fat. These both are similar to each other, yet both are inefficient and cannot reduce body fat. In fact, fat was acting inversely, which means when we try to reduce the food intake or try to exercise more, we gain more weight. After a great observation and dedicated research, the culprit of the fat was caught and the statement was made public. Our body's shape is defined by what foods we take in, not what exercise we do. Any diet can be made healthy or at least healthier, from vegan to meat heavy, if the high glycemic index carbohydrates and sugars are removed or reduced significantly. Gary Topes, why we get fat and what to do about it. Insulin makes us fat. Insulin is what tells our cells to store energy and transfer energy to our muscle tissues. When we eat carbohydrates, for example sweets like bread, potatoes, rice, noodles, etc., our bloodstream gets flooded with sugar in the form of glucose, forcing our body to release insulin. As high blood sugar levels aren't healthy, insulin has to get rid of the excess sugar either by directly using it as energy or storing it as fat. The body stores excessive energy for tough times. Since our ancestors don't always have food, they used to survive on the energy stored as fat. Growing fat cells require more energy. A growing child needs lots of energy, which makes the child constantly hungry, but also makes it have less energy for other activities. Similarly, when we grow fatter, we feel more lethargic and experience an increased appetite to satisfy the energy demands of the growing fat cells. To know more about it in detail, you can get the book. Links are in the description below. we didn't evolve with as many carbohydrates as available today. For 2.5 million years, evolution tailored our body to adapt best to our diets. But flour became only a part of our nutrition in the last 12,000 years. Before the rise of agriculture, our ancestors lived as hunters and gatherers. As such, their nutrition consists mainly of meat, fish, and fruits. In other words, their diets were opposite our modern diets, which means mostly out of carbohydrates. Insulin resistance and other problems. Long-term overexposure can make cells irresponsive to insulin signaling. By eating foods rich in carbohydrates all the time, we cause a constant release of insulin, which can cause diabetes or high blood pressure over the long term. The regular insulin rushes causes our cells to become resistant to the signal, which in course causes the body to release more insulin, causing a catch-22 situation. Avoid foods rich in carbohydrates to lose weight. Since calories get stored as fat only when insulin is released, Gary Tobes, the author of Why We Get Fat, argues that we should get rid of foods rich in carbohydrates. The sweeter the food, the more simple, easy digestible carbohydrates it contains, and the more likely it will make us fat. Sugar-containing drinks must be avoided, and even cereal products and starchy foods contain a lot of carbohydrates. Vegetables, in contrast, have low impact on blood sugar and thus releases less insulin. If we get more slow digestible food in our diet instead of sugar-rich foods, we not only prevent the storage of fat, but we also help our body to release fat as energy. Sugar, the sweet poison. We will discuss sugar in the next video. If you haven't subscribed yet, subscribe it now. Next video will blow your mind. If you find this video informative, then share it with your friends and family. Before going, I would like to ask a small task. If you really like this video, then raise your thumb and smash that like icon. YouTube's algorithm will handle the rest of the process on behalf of you. Thank you for listening. We will meet you in the next episode. Until then, work hard.